There, a hand over here.
Yeah, I was. I'm Bobby. I'm an alcoholic.
Bobo.
Chippy.
Chippy.
You know, when I came in here, I crawled into a church basement window in New Jersey. Drunk as a skunk, you know. And I didn't think, and I was desperate, and I thought my drinking wasn't like your guys' drinking. Because I was physically addicted to drinking, you know what I mean? It was like heroin to me. If I didn't drink 24/7, I would get physically sick. You know, I'd throw up when I get sick. And I know today that there's a lot of people in these rooms that aren't of my low bottom drunk that I am, you know? Because I've gone out, and I last the day, and I'm in the hospital, you know what I mean? And then I get clean, and I get congestive heart failure 2 weeks ago. You know, it's like my body's shot, you know? I really, from the time I was 14 to the time 49, there was 6 years of not sobriety, dryness, you know, that I went to AA, but I didn't help anybody. I helped myself to AA, you know what I mean? I helped, and I got all the gifts, and I got, you know, a restaurant and this and that, but I didn't give back anything. I just took until it took me out again. And I've struggled the last 10 years to come back and stay back. And you know, you're saying in the beginning of the meeting, you know, reaching your hand out and helping somebody is, you know, a lot to do. And, you know, there was a guy here this afternoon that he was at out of rehab, his first day out, and went home, and his wife didn't want him back, you know. You know, and I saw him walking around my neighborhood today. I told him to come over and hang out for a while, you know, and came over and hung out for a couple of hours because he didn't have nowhere to go, you know, poor bastard, you know. And I felt good about that because that's what I'm supposed to do, you know, that's the right thing to do, you know. I'm not supposed to go home and watch, you know, whatever, or, you know, I'm unemployed now, so I can't work. And I don't know, it was just, I'm sure, you know, it's the right thing to do, and usually I don't do the right thing, you know. That's my M.O., you know, to weasel my way around whatever, you know. My motto was always, you know, what's in it for me? What's my end, you know? And I have to change that. And, you know, I read this story before, and tons of times, you know, and it says one, sense of duty, two, it's a pleasure, three, because I'm doing, I am paying the debt to a man who passed it on to me, and four, because every time I do it, I take a little more insurance against myself, taking a slip, and, you know, I'm glad that I'm realizing that today. That's all I have to share.
Thanks for sharing.
Thanks, Bobby.
I'll finish up and say, you know, when I first started sponsoring people, it scared the hell out of me. And I'll tell you why it scared me, because I was afraid you would find out. I didn't know what the hell I was doing here. When you found out that my knowledge of the 12 steps, I didn't know what I was doing. But I became confident by learning more about the 12 steps. Number one, the more people I took through the steps, the more I was forced to learn about the steps, the more I was forced to go into the book and find other people who could teach me what I was doing. And the basic idea is so simple, it really is, that selfishness is at the root of alcoholism, and selflessness is the key to getting out of it. And the form of selflessness that we take in here is for me to give of my time to another person and not expect anything in return from them. Never to say, well, you better do this or you better do that, and don't you call me if you... That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard in AA. That's conditions. When I place conditions on what I do for somebody else, it cancels it out as a selfless act. I get no benefits of being selfless from it. But anyway, like I was saying, I learned more about this 12 steps by taking other people through them, because I was forced to answer questions that I never would have asked to begin with. Mm-hmm. I was forced to learn more about it to keep from looking like an idiot who's just walking around here and didn't know what the hell he was doing. Everybody was going to, I was always, that was one of my biggest fears. When I wrote the fears list, I had a fear of looking like an idiot, because I was always around idiots and I was like, man, that guy's a complete idiot. What the hell am I doing with him? You know, something like that. But anyway, the 12 steps are very simple, and I got to tell you, I didn't just jump into it and say one day, oh, let's go get them, you know, I'm going to go sponsor people. My sponsor said, there's one of your sponsees, and I remember, if he didn't make me do it, I probably wouldn't have done it. But anyway, next week we'll read two or three more pages of Dr. Bob's Nightmare. Probably talk about the same things we did tonight. Maybe give a little insight into the inventory to find what's blocking you from God, and to ask God to enter your heart and help you expel anger and fear and guilt. And the way that we do that in AA, we got a volunteer.